ASRB NET 2018-2. So this exam will happens in December 2018 when I was studying my second year MSc. So these all questions are memory based. For the first time, I cleared national eligibility test in December 2018. So my name is N. H. Shankar Reddy and I am doing PhD plant pathology, Annamalai University. So the first one is agar-agar is produced from. So agar-agar is produced from red algae, Gelidium species. So the next one is, I think we had seen this question paper many times in 2008 NET 1 also we had seen this question paper. It is a very important question. Most of the time this question will be there in a NET question paper. So agar-agar is produced from red algae. The species is Gelidium species. Some other species also will be there in the useful in the production of agar-agar. But this Gelidium species is the most commonly used species in the production of agar-agar. The next one is, durable cell wall can be seen in which family of bacteria? They are asking Firmicutes, Gracilicutes, Tenericutes, something like that. I had given option. The answer is Firmicutes because they are asking durable cell wall in the sense a thick cell wall. We know very well that gram-positive cell wall is very thick compared to gram-negative cell wall because gram-positive cell wall, 85% of mucopeptides is there. So due to presence of huge amount of mucopeptides, the gram-positive cell wall is very thick compared to gram-negative cell wall because gram-negative cell wall consists of 3 to 12% of mucopeptides only, whereas gram-positive cell wall consists of 85% of mucopeptides. So that is the reason where gram-positive cell wall is very thick. So we know very well that gram-positive comes under Firmicutes. And gram-negative bacteria comes under Gracilicutes. So the next question is example of vivotoxin. Example of vivotoxin. So these are all the examples that had been given in options. Fusaric acid, pyriculurin, lycomarasmin. The answer is all the above. So these all the toxins are that comes under vivotoxin. Don't get confused that pyriculurin is a pathotoxin. Yes, of course, it's a strictly a pathotoxin, but it is also comes under vivotoxin. But the main, if you heard the name vivotoxin, you have to come up with the first name, that is fusaric acid. We know very well three types of toxins are present. So pyrotoxin, vivotoxin and pathotoxin. Example of pyrotoxin is alternaric acid. And other examples also will be there. I'm telling the basic one, I mean important one. And the example of vivotoxin is fusaric acid. And the example of pathotoxin is pyriculurin. But here in the option, all the three answers are reliable. So that the option is, I mean the answer is all the above. Fusaric acid, pyriculurin and lycomarasmin. The next one is favorable temperature required for juice spore and sporangial germination in Phytophthora. So in earlier question papers itself we had seen that for the germination of juice spores of Phytophthora that will require 12 degree centigrade, and for the germination of sporangia the Phytophthora will require 18 to 24, in between 18 to 24, and the options given is 12 to 24, 16 to 20, something like that options has been given. So the answer is 12 degree centigrade for juice spore germination, 24 degree centigrade for sporangial germination. So the next one is Ishtilagocytamine causes which disease of sugarcane? We know very well that sugarcane whip smut is caused by Ishtilagocytamine. The new name of Ishtilagocytamine is Porisorium cytamine. So sugarcane whip smut is caused by Ishtilagocytamine. New name is Porisorium cytamine. So the next one is father of soil solarization. So Jacko Cotton is considered as father of soil solarization. In India, Satish Lodha is considered as father of soil solarization in India. In India, Satish Lodha. Next one is parasexuality was discovered by. Actually, parasexuality was discovered by two scientists, Pontecorvo and Roper. In the options, only one scientist has been given. That's why I mentioned only one scientist. The two scientists who discovered the parasexuality is Pontecorvo and Roper in the year of 1952. So they discovered parasexuality mechanism in a fungi called Aspergillus nidulans. Aspergillus nidulans. We know very well that what is parasexuality. Parasexuality, na? What is parasexuality? Plasmogamy, karyogamy, meiosis not occurs in a regular stage or regular intervals at a specified points. Very simple. Plasmogamy, karyogamy, meiosis not occurs in a regular stage at regular intervals. That's it. So the next one is the term phytoalexin was introduced by Muller and Borger. Only one option has been given. Borger was not there. So that's why I placed one. So the term phytoalexin was given by Muller and Borger. If Borger, better to remember Borger also. If any one of the scientists has been given, that will be easy to find it out. So phytoalexin introduced by Muller and Borger in the year of 1940. The first phytoalexin that they discovered is pisatin. First phytoalexin that they discovered is pisatin. We know very well that what is phytoalexin. Phyto means plant. Alexin means protecting substances or to ward off. Ward off in the sense, if there is microbes or if any plant pathogens are coming to attack the plants, these phytoalexins are the substances, low molecular weight substances, which are produced in the plant that can act as a invading substances or protective substances against plant pathogens. Simply for your understanding, I'm telling. The definition will be a little bit different. But the phytoalexins are the plant protecting substances or low molecular weight plant protecting substances that is produced by the plant against plant pathogen. So that was first discovered by Muller and Borger in the year of 1940. So the first phytoalexin discovered is pisatin. First phytoalexin discovered is pisatin. So the next one is Kittelsen killer. Kittelsen killer Kapton. Kapton was invented in the year 1952. Kapton was invented in the year 1952. The invented scientist is Kittelsen. That's why they named as Kittelsen killer. Kapton is otherwise called as Kittelsen killer. Invented in the year 1952. So the next one is Soda Bodox is otherwise called as Burgundy Mitcher. Soda Bodox otherwise called as Burgundy Mitcher. The other name of Burgundy Mitcher. Sorry, other name of Burgundy Mitcher is Soda Bodox. We know about Bodo Mitcher, Burgundy Mitcher and compositions. Although composition we will know very well. So we'll see the next one. So the next question is kernel bunt of wheat was first reported in India by Mitra in the year of 1931. So in the area where he discovered this bunt disease is kernel. That's why they named it kernel bunt. Kernel is the area where the first bunt disease can be discovered in India by Mitra in 1931. So if you see, the bunt infected plant by infected fields will produce a trimethyl amine, a chemical. Due to that, the fish odor or different types of bad smell odor that we can observe if we are passing through or if you are passing side by the infected fields. The reason of this fish odor or that bad odor is trimethyl amine. So the next one is stem rust rules in India was initiated by Mehta. Actually, Indian stem rust rules was written by Nagarajan and Singh, whereas Pakshiniya pathway was written by Nagarajan and Joshi. But in the options, I never seen that Nagarajan and Joshi or Nagarajan and Singh. But among the given scientists, Mehta is completely related to this stem, because other scientists are not at all related to mycology or not at all related to this stem rusts. So that's why I think it might be Mehta. So the next one is environmental factors was first studied by. We know very well that Van der Planck is considered as father of plant disease epidemiology. He was the first to study environmental factors, and he is considered as father of plant disease epidemiology. He wrote a famous book. Actually, he wrote 5 books. Among that, one famous book, Plant Disease Epidemics and Control, which was released in the year 1963. And he introduced and given the many concepts like monocyclic diseases, polycyclic diseases, vertifolia effect, horizontal resistance, vertical resistance, AUDPC. All the concepts was given by Van der Planck only. The next one is the term elicitor was coined by. The term elicitor was coined by Noel Keane. He is also considered as father of molecular plant pathology. So the next question is, nucleic acid is the infectious material of plant virus was first given by. So Geirer and Schramm was first to discover that nucleic acid is the infectious material of plant virus in 1956. They concluded that virus consists of two ingredients, that is protein coat and as well as nucleic acid. Protein coat is the protective structure where the nucleic acid is packed inside, and it also offers a protection to the nucleic acid. And here Geirer and Schramm concluded that nucleic acid is the infectious material, whereas protein coat is the only protective material, and it has no role in disease causing or disease spread. That was given by Geirer and Schramm. But if you see W.M. Stanley thought that protein coat is the infectious material of plant virus, but that's not true. In later days, Geirer and Schramm concluded that nucleic acid, which is packed inside, is the infectious material of plant virus, whereas protein coat only protects the nucleic acid, and it has no role in disease spread and as well as disease transmission. So the next one is systemic acquired resistance depends on the external application of. I think we had seen this question earlier. So the systemic acquired resistance depends on the application of salicylic acid. We know very well systemic acquired resistance requires salicylic acid, whereas induced systemic resistance requires jasmonic acid and ethylene. If it is a SAR, so external application of salicylic acid is required. If it is a ISR, induced systemic resistance, jasmonic acid and ethylene are involved in induced systemic resistance pathway. So the next one is Reisz-Kyrre disease is caused by zinc deficiency. We know very well Reisz-Kyrre disease was reported by Y.L. Nene. So Reisz-Kyrre is due to zinc deficiency. If you want to rectify this zinc deficiency, we can apply zinc sulfate so that this disease can be rectified, because it's a deficiency of zinc. It's abiotic disorder. So the next one is citrus motile leaf is due to. So citrus motile leaf is also due to the zinc deficiency. So the next one is hollow heart of turnip and cauliflower is caused by. I don't know the answer. It seems to be the manganese, but I don't know whether it's a manganese or magnesium or some other else. If you know, just comment below. So the next one is best suitable method for the control of soil borne diseases. So let me show you the answer that I had given. So the next one is, sorry for the last one, I don't know, because what are the best suitable method for the management of soil borne diseases. I think options are almost all are reliable, because if there is for the management of soil borne diseases, we can go for soil solarization and crop rotation and other techniques can be crop rotation can't be the perfect one, but soil solarization definitely a best management practices for soil borne diseases. But I don't know, all the answers seems to be, all the options that I has given seems to be the reliable. That's why I left it. And if you know, just comment below. The next, they had given like this, white tip nematode. Actually, I placed it in a right way, but they had shuffled it in a some other way. That's why I placed it like they had asked in question like this. White tip of rice, which is caused by Aphelingoidus basi. Rice root nematode, Melodogyne incognita. Reniform nematode, Rotulinchus reniformis. Wheat eucoccal nematode, Anguna tritici. But they shuffled the answers. That's why I collected and I placed it in a right form here. So make sure that we can also expect many questions from nematode, especially these causal organisms. Not causal organisms, they're scientific names. So scientific names are it's better to remember at least some basic basic terms and basic important scientific names in nematology. And the next question is suitable management practices for Schlieroschen ralphsi, and the options given were given here: the irrigation, application of carboxin or application of propiconazole, and the application of trichoderma and strobilurin group of fungicides. So among that, it seems to be application of trichoderma seems to be reliable, because it's a soil borne, it's a biocontrol agent that can be better recommended for soil borne diseases. Definitely application of carboxin and irrigation was definitely not, and maybe strobilurin and application of propiconazole also not reliable for Schlieroschen ralphsi, but it seems to be the application of trichoderma is reliable. It might be wrong also sometimes. So if you know, just comment below. So the next one is teleomorphic stage of alternaria, teleomorphic stage, sexual stage, meiotic stage, all are same. Teleomorph, sexual stage, meiotic stage, we have the same meaning. That is, they are asking sexual stage of alternaria, whereas alternaria is the asexual stage. So are anamorphic stage. Now the teleomorphic or sexual stage of alternaria is levia or levia. The next one is toxin produced by Pyricularia varizae or Magnoporthe graece. So here these are all the toxins that I had given. Pyricularin we know very well. Alpha picolinic acid also is a toxin which is produced by a rice blast pathogen. But I was a little bit doubt about Pyricula. I don't know whether it was produced by Pyricularia varizae or not. But Pyricularin and alpha picolinic acid are the definitely a toxins which are produced by rice blast pathogen, that is Pyricularia varizae or Magnoporthe graece. But maybe Pyricularia, I never heard of Pyricula so far. Maybe there might be a chance, because if you see the options, they had given these three options and the last one is all the above. Definitely it might be all the above, because we know very well that Pyricularin and alpha picolinic acid are the definitely a toxin that is produced by Pyricularin. So we don't have any another option to go only one, because they never given like A and B, something like that. Three options and our last option is all the above. So definitely the Pyricula also is a toxin which is produced by Pyricularia. I think so. I'm not sure. If you know, just comment below please. The next one is filiform, not piliform. Filiform ascospore is produced by Claviceps. So filiform type of ascospore, filiform means like this. This is the filiform shape of ascospore, like simply, for your understanding, I can simply say rod shape like that. So filiform ascospore is produced by Claviceps. So the next one is muriform conidia is produced by Alternaria. Muriform in the sense, a conidia which is having both vertical and horizontal septations is known as muriform conidia, which is produced by Alternaria. The conidia will be like this, which has in the both vertical and both horizontal septa. That is Alternaria. It's the best example. One more example will also be there, actually I forgot, but the most important or the most highest preference will goes to Alternaria only, because we are seeing this question from past 5-10 years. So for muriform conidia you can go for Alternaria. The next one is Podospora leucotrica produces how many ascus, not ascospores, we can observe here. Podospora leucotrica produce only one ascus. We know very well that in ascomycota group, all the ascus contains 8 number of ascospores. Few of them contains maybe 16, like example of trichoderma, rufite produce 16. Some may produce 512, that is podospora, not podosparia. And here in this Podosporia leucotrica, I think it's a powdery mildew of rose or maybe, I'm not sure, just please refer it. So this Podospora leucotrica will produce only one ascus. And the next one is size of bean common mosaic virus. The size of bean common mosaic virus is 750 into 12 nanometer in diameter. The next one is genome of pi x phase. Genome of pi x phase is double stranded DNA. The pi x phase genome is composed of double stranded DNA. In few occasions, in a very small occasion, single stranded DNA also can be observed, but most of the pi x phases contains double stranded DNA as a genetic material. And the next one is peach leaf curl of Gemini virus. They are trying to confuse us. Leaf curl or comes under Gemini virus. So what are all the virus? All the virus that comes under Gemini virus, whose genome is composed of single stranded DNA. If it is a virus that comes under Gemini virus, go with blind, whose genome is made up of single stranded DNA only. Peach leaf curl is a virus that comes under Gemini virus, whose genome is made up of single stranded DNA. All the Gemini viridae, all the viruses that comes under Gemini viridae or Gemini virus, whose genome is composed of single stranded DNA only. So the next one, lambda phase consists of. So they're asking lambda phase consists of lytic phase or lysogenic phase or only lytic phase or only lysogenic phase. We know very well lambda phase consists of both the lytic phase and the lysogenic phase. So lytic phase is considered as virulent phase. Other name of lytic phase is virulent phase. We know very well. And whereas lysogenic phase is considered as temperate phase, because in lytic phase, bacterial cell is lysed and the bacteria was killed by this bacteriophage. Whereas in lysogenic phase, temperate phase, why they are named as temperate phase? The bacteriophage don't kill the bacteria. Instead of killing, the bacteriophage genome is integrated with the bacterial genome, so that the characters of bacteriophage also can be expressed. That's why it's called, that's why lambda phase consists of both the lytic phase and the lysogenic phase. We know very well that in industrial microbiology or industrial purpose, lysogenic phase is the most suitable phase for the production of different types of drugs or production of different strains of antibiotics. We know very well. The next one is simple interested diseases produces a curve. So simple interested diseases produces saturation curve. We have three types of curves will be there. That is produced by simple, so not produced by simple interest. Simple interested diseases, these are all the measure of disease rate or disease intensity. So the simple interested diseases, it can't measure. So based on their duration or their severity, we can divide it into are based on the life cycle that it completes. The first one is simple interested diseases. Second one is compound interested diseases. Third one is polyetic diseases. Simple interested diseases which produce a curve called saturation curve. Whereas compound interested diseases which produces a curve is called sigmoid curve or S-shaped curve. Polyetic diseases will produce a curve called bimodal curve. We know very well simple interested diseases are monocyclic diseases, in the sense the pathogen completes life cycle within a year, that is monocyclic diseases. Whereas compound interested diseases will complete many generations of life cycles in a single year, that is compound interested disease, otherwise called as polycyclic. Number of cycles will happen in a single year, that is called polycyclic. Produces sigmoid curve or S-shaped curve. Whereas polyetic diseases, the pathogens will require more than 1 year. That means maybe 1 year or 2 years, it will take more than 2 years to complete life cycle, is called polyetic diseases. Example of polyetic diseases is Dutch elm disease and citrus distichia virus. These are all comes under polyetic disease. Saturation curve, root rots, wilts also comes under root rots and wilts are comes under simple interested disease. For compound interest disease, we can go for wheat stem rust and other diseases. So the next one is signaling pathway between host and pathogen. So the CAMP and MAP, I think cyclic adenosine monophosphate pathway and mitogen activated phosphate kinase, is these two are the signaling pathways in between the host and pathogen. And during host and pathogen interaction also, these two pathways are the very important one, and then it was followed by some other PAMP, DAMP, something else. But these two are the initial signaling pathways of the host-pathogen interaction. CAMP means cyclic adenosine monophosphate pathway. MAP, M-A-P-K means mitogen activated phosphate kinase. If there is any mistakes, you just please comment below. And the next one is plant shows resistance to all types of resistance is called horizontal resistance. We will know very well that vertical resistance is a complete resistance. Vertical resistance gives complete resistance against few races only, whereas horizontal resistance provide partial resistance, but wide range of pathogens can be covered. That's why they are called as vertical resistance is a complete resistance against few races of pathogen, not all the races. Whereas horizontal resistance is a resistance that provide partial resistance against all the races of pathogen. That's why most of the breeding techniques will go with horizontal resistance, because it provide a broad spectrum resistance against variety of pathogens. Broad spectrum of pathogens. So the next one is carborundum powder is used too. So carborundum powder in local lesion assay, we use carborundum powder. The purpose of carborundum powder is to make wounds in the plants. So the carborundum powder, the chemical name of carborundum powder is silicon carbide. So which we use this silicon carbide or carborundum powder is to make wounds in the plants. Then only we can perform local lesion assay, or then only we can perform Then only we can perform some other test that is called, you know, sap transmission. You know, sap transmission, we can test it in lab so that we can use carborundum powder to make wounds so that only we can, the sap that we are collected from the outside, if we rub it into the plant surfaces, the wounds made by the carborundum powder so that the pathogen can easily enter into the plant cells. So the carborundum powder in normally used for to make wounds in the plants. The next one is groundnut bud necrosis virus. So groundnut, they asked groundnut bud necrosis is a fungi or bacteria or virus or viroid, something like that. They had given options. So the answer is virus. We know very well that groundnut bud necrosis virus, groundnut bud necrosis is a viral disease. So the next one is Taphrina deformans causes which disease? So Taphrina deformans causes peach leaf curl disease. So the next one is turmeric leaf blotch is caused by, turmeric leaf blotch is caused by Taphrina maculans. So next one is banana streak virus is transmitted by, banana streak virus is transmitted by mealybug. Not only banana streak virus, one more important disease, that is cocoa sholen soot, which is also transmitted by mealybug. Banana streak virus and cocoa sholen soot virus, both are transmitted by mealybug. So the scientific name of mealybug is Pseudococcus nigellensis. The next one is most sensitive method for the detection of plant viruses. ELISA is the most sensitive technique for the detection of plant viruses. The sensitivity of ELISA is, sorry, it's not picogram, it's a nanogram. So ELISA sensitivity is 10 nanogram per ml, whereas PCR sensitivity is 10 picogram per ml. The smallest unit is nanogram only. That's why ELISA is the most sensitive technique for the detection of plant viruses. We know very well that ELISA was discovered by Clark and Adams in 1977. So the next one is chrysanthemum stunt is due to. So chrysanthemum stunt is a viroid disease, not viral disease. So the next one is little leaf of brinjal is caused by. So little leaf of brinjal is a phytoplasmal disease, we know very well. So almost all phytoplasmal diseases are transmitted by leafhopper only. Here little leaf of brinjal is transmitted by a leafhopper species. I think Hishimonas piceatis, I'm not sure. If you know, just comment below. So the next one is botrytis cinerea sporulation is seen in the presence of. So if you see all other fungi and other pathogenic fungi, the sporulation can be inhibited in the presence of UV rays. Sporulation can be inhibited in the presence of UV rays. Whereas botrytis cinerea sporulation can be seen or can be increased due to the presence of UV rays. It's completely opposite to the almost all fungi. So the next one is a viral parasite. So I didn't remember what are the options that I had given. If you know, just comment below. The next one is artificial culturing of fungal spores was first identified by, I don't know this, options also I didn't remember. If you know, just comment below. So the next one is genus Clostridium was identified by, actually genus Clostridium was identified with Promvozzi, but in options there is no Promvozzi, but Louis Pasteur and other scientists has been given. I don't think so, what will be the answer. If you know, just comment below, who had an experience and written in 2018 too. If you know, just please comment below. So the next one is ICTV was established in the year, ICTV, International Committee on Taxonomy of Virus, established in the year 1973, whereas ICNV, International Committee on Nomenclature of Virus, which is established in the year 1966. The same ICNV which was established in 1966, which is name changed to ICTV, that is International Committee on Taxonomy of Virus, in the year 1973. ICNV 1966, Nomenclature of Virus. ICTV, Taxonomy of Virus, 1973. So the next one is Cenocytic Mycelium, non-septate mycelium or aseptate mycelium, which is produced by. So we know very well that Oomycota group of fungi produces cenocytic mycelium or non-septate mycelium or aseptate mycelium. Among the options given, Phytophthora is only the option that comes under Oomycota. Remaining all are Ascomycota or some other fungi. So the next one is Hortig nets are found in ectomycorrhizae. That's a very important one. So the next one is ectoparasitic fungi. I don't know the options and as well as I don't remember the option and as well as the answer also. If you know, just comment below. So the next one is fungus used for genetic studies. So the fungi used for genetic studies is Neurospora crassa, where it is normally called as pin mold or red bread mold. If it is a bacteria, Agrobacterium is normally used for genetic studies. If it is a virus, tobacco mosaic virus and cauliflower mosaic virus are generally used for genetic studies. If it is a nematode, Chino rhabdis elegans, which is used for genetic studies. So the next one is PTGS are discovered in PTGS, the phenomenon of PTGS, post-transcriptional gene silencing or RNA interference or co-suppression. Post-transcriptional gene silencing, otherwise called as RNA interference. It was discovered in nematode, that is Chino rhabdis elegans. It is a nematode where the post-transcriptional gene silencing mechanism has been observed. If it is in plants, it is called PTGS, that is post-transcriptional gene silencing. If it is in maybe animal viruses, or, maybe in animals or some other organisms, it is called as RNA interference. The mechanism in fungi is called quelling, but we can commonly call it the same name, that is RNA interference or PTGS. That was discovered in an organism, Chino rhabdis elegans, that is the nematode. It is also the nematode for model organisms nematode studies. So the next one is, more than this PTGS was discovered by two scientists, Andrew Fier and Craig Mello, that was discovered in the nematode Chino rhabdis elegans in 1998. So the for the discovery of this RNA interference or gene silencing mechanism, so Andrew Fier and Craig Mello received Nobel Prize in 2006. So the next one is Delovibrio is a, so Delovibrio is a gram negative actually. So Delovibrio is a gram negative bacterium. We know very well a bacterium that infects another bacterium is called Delovibrio. So the Delovibrio were first time discovered by Slope. STLOP. Slope was first to discover Delovibrio in the year of 1962. So Delovibrio is a gram-negative bacterium. This next one is mycoparasitism. Mycoparasitism in between fungi and fungi. The name itself indicates myco means fungi. We know very well. Parasitism between fungi and fungi, that is called mycoparasitism. So the next one is hypersensitive response is seen in which crop? So hypersensitive response can be commonly seen or commonly observed in tobacco crop. The next question is enzyme produced by Irvinia amylovora. So the enzyme normally produced by Irvinia amylovora is amylovorin. So we know very well Irvinia amylovora, which causes fire blight of apple. So it is the fire blight of apple and pear is the first plant pathogenic bacteria discovered. So it is the first plant pathogenic bacteria that is discovered. Irvinia amylovora, fire blight of apple, that was discovered by T.J. Burrill in the year of 1882. It's not 1878 because he had an idea he wrote a paper to some other authorities like, you know, it could be the new idea if it is true. The bacteria could be the first agent, bacteria could be the agent that is also responsible for the causing of plant diseases. So his idea will be something new, and those time in 1878, and he carried the experiments in 1879, 80 and 81, and in 1882 he concluded that Irvinia amylovora, which is responsible for fire blight of apple and pear, that is fire blight of apple and pear, which is caused by Irvinia amylovora. It is the first plant pathogenic bacterium that is discovered, and it is discovered by T.J. Burrill in the year of 1882. He is also considered as founder of plant bacteriology, not father, because we know very well that E.F. Smith is considered as father of plant bacteriology. But T.J. Burrill is considered as founder of plant bacteriology. So the next one is Cuscuta obtains food through. So I never remembered the option, but at my knowledge of at present, it obtains nutrients through Haustoria. Not only Cuscuta, but also almost all plant panerogamic plant parasites are obtained nutrients through Haustoria only. Because most of the phanerogamic plant parasites do not produce any roots. So if you take Cuscuta and you can take Loranthus, it don't produce any internal roots or external roots. Instead of roots, they have root caps. So this Cuscuta, Loranthus, Warabanki, Striga, all the phanerogamic plant parasites are obtained nutrients through Haustoria. But they mentioned here food. So whether they mean it is a nutrients or whatever it is, I don't know. But it's been very long, so I don't even remember the options also. If you know, just comment below. So the next one is gram negative bacteria belonging to the family. Gram negative bacteria belonging to the family Gramsci. Gram positive bacteria belonging to the family Firmicutes. Please make sure note of it, because we had seen this question earlier also. I mean 2018 one net question paper also. So gram negative bacteria belonging to the family Gramsci. Gram positive bacteria belonging to the family Firmicutes. We know very well lipoteichoic acid is present in gram positive bacteria, whereas it is absent in gram negative bacteria. Gram positive bacterial cell wall is very thick because high amount of mucopeptides, that is 85%, whereas gram negative bacterial cell wall is very thin because of absence of lipoteichoic acid and high amount of lipoteichoic acid where it is present in gram positive. So instead of peptidoglycan, the gram negative bacteria cell wall is made up of 3 to 12% of peptidoglycan, and the remaining are other portion of the cell wall is made up of polysaccharides. So the next one is flagella all over the body. They're asking flagella types. So flagella all over the bodies is peritrichus. Flagella all over bodies peritrichus. The best example is Erwinia. Erwinia that comes under peritrichus type of flagella. So the next one is bean wilt could be maintained in the laboratory. I think it's a 24 years. I don't know whether it was there in the option or not. Bean wilt, I think Cartobacterium flaccumfaciens or something like that. Bean wilt, Cartobacterium flaccumfaciens, subspecies flaccumfaciens, I'm not sure. If it is a bean wilt, that is Cartobacterium flaccumfaciens, definitely it is a 24 hours. In the laboratory conditions, the bean wilt pathogen can be stored at 24 years. Sorry, not 24 hours, 24 years. The next question is bacterial cell wall is made up of. So bacterial cell wall is made up of peptidoglycan or mucopeptides. So the amount of peptidoglycan or mucopeptides varies from bacteria to bacteria. We know where, I mean gram positive to gram negative, that varies. Gram positive bacteria contains 85% of mucopeptides or peptidoglycan, whereas gram negative bacteria contains 3 to 12% of mucopeptides or peptidoglycan. So next one is virus movement from one cell to another cell. Virus movement from one cell to another cell is facilitated by. So virus movement from one cell to another cell is facilitated by Plasmodesmata, because the virus is smaller than Plasmodesmata. How it is moved through Plasmodesmata? Because the viruses produce a movement protein. Due to the presence of or due to the production of a movement protein, even though the viruses are smaller than the Plasmodesmata, with the mediation of that movement protein, the viruses which moves from one cell to another cell through Plasmodesmata. So the next one is 8th edition of Berge's Manual of Determinative Bacteriology, which was edited by. So the 8th edition of Berge's Manual of Determinative Bacteriology was edited by R.E. Buchan and Gibbons. So the next one is Protomyces macrosporus, that is crown gall of coriander, sorry, stem gall of coriander, which Protomyces macrosporus matured conia can spread through. I think it's air, I'm not sure. If you know, just comment below. So the next one is father of plant pathology in India. We know very well E.J. Butler is considered as father of plant pathology and father of mycology in India. Whereas in world level, father of mycology is P.A. Michelli. But father of plant pathology, or father of experimental plant pathology, or father of modern experimental plant pathology, that is Anton DeBerry. In India, father of plant pathology and father of mycology, both are A.J. Butler only. I hope you'll know that he wrote a famous book called Fungi and Diseases in Plants, which was released in the year 1918. So the next question is Indian Phytopathological Society was started by. Phytopathological Society in India was started by B.B. Munkur. We know that Indian Phytopathological Society was started February 28, 1947, but the entire setup and everything will the function will start in the year of 1948. So Indian Phytopathological Society established or started by B.B. Munkur, and he wrote a famous book called Fungi and Plant Diseases, which was released in the year 1948. So the next one is 1 gram solution in 50% active ingredient, not 50 active ingredients mixed in 1 liter of water, then what will be the concentration in ppm? So it's a 500 ppm. If you know the calculation, just go for it. It's a 500 ppm. So the next one is Striga is a partial root parasite. We know very well that Cuscuta, Loranthus, Warabanki, Striga. So Cuscuta is a complete stem parasite. So whereas Loranthus is a partial stem parasite. Warabanki is a complete root parasite. Striga is a partial root parasite. So the next one is nucleic acid molecular weight of bacteria. The nucleic acid molecular weight of bacteria is 1.5 into 10 to the power of 9 Dalton. So they had given in a Dalton. So molecular weight of bacteria is 1.5 into 10 to the power of 9 million Dalton. And they're also asked one more question, that is a molecular weight of bacterial chromosome. I'm not sure whether it's a 5 into 10 power 10 to the power of 7, or some of the book shows 5 into 10 to the power of 9 also. But among the given options, 5 into 10 to the power of 7 seems to be the reliable, and also I had studied it somewhere else. But I'm not sure. If you know the answer, just please comment below. What will be the molecular weight of a bacterial chromosome? Let me come to know. So the same question repeat here. The next one is Bendy yellowing mosaic virus is transmitted by. So the Bendy yellowing mosaic virus is transmitted by white fly, that is Bemisia tabaci. So the next one is potato mosaic virus belonging to the family. So potato mosaic virus belonging to the family Poteovirus. So the molecular weight of tobacco mosaic virus. So the molecular weight of tobacco mosaic virus is 39 million Dalton. Whereas nucleic acid molecular weight of tobacco mosaic virus is 2 into 10 to the power of 6 Dalton. Whereas molecular weight of TMV molecular weight is 39 million Dalton. Whereas nucleic acid molecular weight is 2 into 10 to the power of 6. So we can expect at least one or two questions from tobacco mosaic virus. We know very well that new tobacco mosaic virus contains 158 amino acids, 2130 coat protein subunits or capsomere subunits, and 6400, if you want a real exact answer, 6395. So make it as a 6400. So 6400 nucleotides that TMV consists of. So at least we can expect one or two questions from TMV. So the next one is both acropetal and basipetal. Acropetal means upward, whereas basipetal means downward direction. Both acropetal and basipetal movement fungicide is the best example for both acropetal and basipetal is Fossetyl aluminium. So Fossetyl aluminium is the best example for both upward and downward movement fungicide. And we can also one more fungicide will be there, that is metaloxyl. So the next one is both systemic and contact fungicide. So metaloxyl is the most systemic and contact fungicide. Among the given option, it seems to be the both systemic and contact fungicide. So the next question is the same question had been asked here. What is the given example of both systemic and contact fungicide? Among the given option, as I said to you earlier, so metaloxyl seems to be the most reliable option. So the next one is anthracnose is best managed by. So anthracnose is best managed by the application of. I don't know the answer. If you know, just comment below. Among the given options, I don't even remember the options whatever they had given. If you know, just comment below. So the fungicide with the nematicidal activity, they had given four options. I don't even know which one is a nematicide, which one is a fungicide at those time. So if you know, just comment below. So because of a number of nematicides are available in market, but our aim is what are all the given options, and that will be very important for me because we have to select from given options only. Yes. So the next one is Jirami is applicable for which disease? These are all the options given. Ergot disease, smut disease, blast of Bajra. These are all the given options. But I don't think that I know whether for all the above, whether Jirami can be used or not. I don't know. Maybe ergot or maybe smut or maybe blast of Bajra. If you know, just comment below. I think it might be the sorghum. It may be ergot because we have carboxin and oxycarboxin for rust and smut, oxycarboxin for rust, for smut, carboxin. For blast of Bajra also, we can go for tricyclosporin or some other fungicide. I think it seems to be ergot. I'm not sure. If you know, just comment below, please. So the next one is Tylosis body present in which disease? I think formation of Tylosis is the very characteristic, common characteristic in terms of wilt diseases. Yes. I think whether it was there in the option or not, I don't know. I'm not sure. But as far of my experience, the formation of tylosis or gas bubbles or vacuoles is the characteristic symptoms of wilted disease, whatever the wilt it is. So the next one is, which bacteria produce blue color stain in while adding to the milk? So if you add Pseudomonas syncassia to the milk, it produces a blue color stain. So if it produces a red color stain, it is a Serratia marcescens. It is Serratia marcescens. Make sure, if it is a blue color stain while adding to the milk, it is a Pseudomonas syncassia. It is a red color stain, it is Serratia marcescens. One more stain will be there, I think I forgot it. It is caused by Pseudomonas aeruginosa, maybe purple color or something else, I'm not sure, but this blue and the red, I can assure you. So the next one is, PCR can amplify. So it is the most debating question since my UG. So most of the papers or most of the experts that they are saying PCR can amplify both the DNA and RNA. I also performed many experiments with this PCR, but as far as my experience, PCR can only amplify DNA. I never seen that in any paper or in any area, I never seen that PCR can amplify RNA also. But most of them are saying that PCR can amplify both the DNA and RNA. If you know, just comment below. The next one is, most suitable medium for culturing organisms. So I thought that it's a potato dextrose medium, but it's not true. Oatmeal agar medium. Oatmeal agar is the most suitable medium for culturing of microorganisms. Why almost all laboratories are using potato dextrose medium? It might be the reason that these are the following reasons. Like, you know, the preparation of oatmeal agar medium is a little bit difficult and more ingredients are required when compared to potato dextrose agar medium. That might be the one of the reason. And moreover, the cost also, maybe I'm not sure whether what will be the cost of ingredients that is required. Maybe dextrose will be required, agar will be required for the potato. If it is a oatmeal, then though I don't know whether it's a readily available composition media will be available or not, or preparation will be a little bit difficult. That's why most of the laboratories that are using potato dextrose medium. But the answer is, oatmeal agar medium is the most suitable medium for the culturing of microorganisms. So the next one is, fungicide which inhibits mitosis synthesis. Among the given options, Benomyl, Thiobendazole, Benzimidazole. All the options are having the activity of mitosis synthesis. So the option is all the above. So the next one is, black tip of mango is by bricklings due to the deficiency of boron deficiency. If sulfur dioxide will be there, it is also one of the responsible, because if the mango orchards are placed nearby bricklings, so the bricklings will produce sulfur dioxide. Due to the sulfur dioxide also, sometimes we can observe black color tips or black color discolorations on the mango. So that devastatingly affects the marketing price, you know. So the black tip of mango mainly is due to the deficiency of boron. Sometimes if it is nearby bricklings, sulfur dioxide is also one of the responsible one. So if you want to manage black tip of mango, you can go for the application of borax. So the next one is, club root of cabbage can be best controlled by. We know very well that club root of cabbage is very severe at 5.5 pH. 5.2 to 5.5, exactly 5.5 pH, the club root of cabbage is very severe, and it can be controlled by if we raise the soil pH to 7.6 to 7.8. How we can raise the soil pH? By the application of lime. 2.5 tons of lime can be applied per 1 hectare to raise the soil pH from 5.5 to 7.6 to 7.8. Whereas one more disease, that is potato scab, which is very severe at the pH of 8.0, and it can be controlled by at the pH of 5.2. In that case, the soil pH we have to get into down. So if you want to reduce the soil pH, you can go for the application of a gypsum. 900 kilograms per hectare can be recommended if you want to reduce the soil pH and you can control the potato scab disease. So the next one is, Syncytrium endobioticum can survive in soil for how many years? I don't know, maybe 5 years or 10 years, I'm not sure, and I don't even remember the options. If you guys will know, just please comment below. So the allowed percentage of kernel burnt of wheat infected seeds is, I'm not sure, it may be 0.25 or something, maybe less than that also. The allowed percentage of kernel burnt of wheat of infected seeds, I don't know. If you know, just comment below. So the next one is, citrus canker can be transmitted by citrus canker can be transmitted by insect vector, that is a leaf miner. It can also transmitted by water splash and wind also, that is citrus canker bacterium. But the majority of the transmission will happens with the leaf miner, that is a vector. So the next one is loss of turbidity and drooping of leaves is the characteristic symptoms of wilt, anthracnose, grapes mildews. So I don't know the answer. It seems to be maybe wilt, loss of turbidity and drooping of leaves. We can also observe in wilt and we can also observe in grapes mildews also. So if you know, just comment below. So in those time while I was writing exam, I don't have that much knowledge to think and to write, you know, to go for answers. So now I'm okay right now to go for not only national eligibility test, but also for ASRB. So if you know, just comment below about this loss of turbidity and drooping of leaves. So the next one is number of septations in conidia of Pericularia varizae. So it's a very, very important. We know Pericularia varizae or Magnoporte graecae is the responsible pathogen for rice blast. That is Pericularia varizae or Magnoporte graecae. So the number of septations, they're asking here, two septations are present, totally three-celled. This is, let us consider, it is the conidia of Pericularia varizae. It consists of two septations. So if you place two septations here, we can find three cells here. 1, 2, 3. So the Pericularia varizae consists of two septations and three cells. It's a very important one. So the next one is blossom endrata of tomato is caused by. So blossom endrata of tomato is a calcium deficiency which is caused by calcium deficiency. So the next one is recent advanced techniques in the identification of virus. So among the given options, RNA interference is the most advanced and recent technique that has been mentioned there. I think it's not identification technique. That's also one of the doubt for me, because you know, it is in a technique where we can silence the virus, or where we can silence the genome of the virus so that the plant disease can be suppressed. Answer might be different also. I'm not sure. If you know, just comment below. Let me discuss. And the next one is secondary fixing agent in electron microscope. I think it's osmium tetroxide is the secondary fixing agent. Osmium tetroxide. So osmium tetroxide is the secondary fixing agent that is used in electron microscope. So the next one is Pseudomonas syringae, which produces wildfire toxin. Pseudomonas syringae pathover tabaci. So it is otherwise called as. So actually answer is all the above, and there will be a debate in here. Let me tell you, wildfire toxin, we know very well Pseudomonas syringae or wildfire toxin is otherwise called as tab toxin, but T toxin, it's a not a name of wildfire toxin that is produced by Pseudomonas syringae pathover tabaci, because the T toxin is something different. They had given like wildfire toxin, tab toxin, T toxin, all the above. So we can't go for only one, because we know very well that wildfire toxin and tab toxins are the other names of Pseudomonas syringae pathover tabaci toxin. So but they had given all the above, and I think it seems to be the wrong options. They had to given like only one option, like wildfire toxin or tab toxin, or they have to given like both A and B, something like that. They had given three options, so one of the option is wrong, and then last one is they had given all the above. So I don't know whether it is also called as a T toxin or something, but as far of my knowledge, the Pseudomonas syringae toxin is otherwise called as wildfire toxin and tab toxin only. It's not T toxin. So the next one is which race of banana that infect Mocovilt? Mocovilt, which is affected by race 2. There are 5 races of Ralstonia solanacea. We know that Mocovilt of banana is called by Ralstonia solanacea arum. So there are 5 races: race 1, race 2, race 3, race 4, race 5. Race 1 will affect Solanaceae. Race 2 affects Musaceae. Race 3 affects potato. Race 4 affects ginger. Race 5 affects mulberry. So remember this, that you, so that you can write easily whatever the race that they are asking. So they are asking which race will affect Mocovilt of banana. We know that banana that comes under the family Musaceae. So race 2 will affect Musaceae, that is banana. If they ask particularly potato, that is race 3, because Solanaceae, there are so many crops that comes under Solanaceae. So if they particularly ask potato, you can go for race 3. Race 4 is ginger and race 5 is mulberry. So you remember this, that so that you can easily answer the given question, whatever they may. So the next one is demicyclic rust means. You know very well, demicyclic rust is lack of iridial stage is called as demicyclic rust. So the next one is which secretion system is found in almost all plant pathogenic bacteria. We know very well that there are six or seven types of secretion systems has been discovered so far. I think by the end of 2019, there are 9 types of secretion systems are discovered in bacteria. But I think last 2 are negligible. I think only 7 secretion systems are important in plant pathogenic bacteria. Among that, type 1 secretion system is found in almost all plant pathogenic bacteria. Whatever the bacteria you take, plant pathogenic bacteria, type 1 secretion system is very common in almost all plant pathogenic bacteria. And there will be a chance of asking this type of questions also. So which secretion system will play a major role in pathogenicity of bacteria? Remember, type 3 secretion system. So type 3 secretion system is very, very important, that plays a very major role in pathogenicity of bacteria. The question, so make sure that you can study the question 2 times, not 1 time. Go for 1 or 2 times, make sure the question is, whether you are studying the question is right or wrong, and then you can go for the answer. Don't do like me, because I was, when I was writing exam, I was very exaggerated, and I was writing like without studying the question. So that was not a right one. So you can study the question twice and then you can go for the option. Here, the type of secretion system which is found in almost all plant pathogenic bacteria, that is type 1. So type 3 secretion system is essential for pathogenicity, make sure of it. So the next one is EpiPre is a forecasting model used for. So EpiPre is a forecasting model that is used for cereal rust EpiPre. So the next one is Irvinia enters into the plant cells through the enzyme. So we know very well that Irvinia produces pectinases enzymes to enter into the plant cells. So pectinases are the enzymes which is produced by the pathogen Irvinia. So the next one is gram positive root nodule nitrogen fixing bacteria. Among the given options, Francia seems to be the reliable. If there is any other bacteria, something else will be there, you just comment below, please. So the next one is new name of Clavibacter xyli, subspecies xyli. We know very well Clavibacter xyli, subspecies xyli, which causes sugarcane rotten stunting. So the new name of sugarcane rotten stunting is Leifsonia xyli, subspecies xyli, which is transmitted through infected cells. So the previous name of sugarcane rotten stunting is Clavibacter xyli, subspecies xyli, and the new name is Leifsonia xyli, subspecies xyli. So the next one is number of segmentation in alpha-alpha mosaic virus. I don't know the answer. If you know, just comment below. So the next one is phytoalaxins. We know very well phyto means plant, alaxins means protecting substances. Phytoalaxins are the plant protection substances which is produced by the plant cells due to. They're asking why phytoalaxins are produced in the plant cells. The reason is production of secondary metabolites. So if the pathogen is producing any secondary metabolites or something like that, and the phytoalaxins are get activated inside the plant cells, and it can ward off the pathogen infections. So the next one is chemical used to reduce the phytotoxicity of another chemical is called. So in applied plant pathology, we can see this. Some of the chemicals can add as a sticker, some of the chemicals as a used to reduce the phytotoxicity of another chemicals. So here the chemical used to reduce the phytotoxicity of another chemicals is normally known as safner. Best example is a lime is the best example of chemical that is used to reduce the phytotoxicity of chemical. So if any chemical that is reducing phytotoxicity, that is called safner. Safner is an agent or chemical which normally used to reduce the phytotoxicity. Let us consider if the phytotoxicity is too much, it will get affected by plants also will get affected. So if you want to reduce the phytotoxicity or toxic level, so safner can be added. The best example of safner is lime. So the next one is which antibody is used in PCR technique. So immunosorbent PCR, which antibody is in PCR. I'm not sure, but options they had given only equipment, but this question seems to be meaningless. But among the options, immunosorbent PCR is the right one. In immunosorbent PCR, antibody can be used. So the next one is quarantine can be applicable for seed-borne diseases only, because we can't control the airborne disease and some other diseases. So quarantine only represent for seed-borne diseases. If there is any seed-borne diseases or the viruses or bacteria or fungi, any other plant pathogenic material which is present in the propagating materials, not only seeds but also root stalks, whatever the propagating material it is, if there is any plant pathogenic organisms will be present, that can be used to detect only seed related or only propagating related, not by airborne or something else. So the next one is inoculum development of Phytophthora infestans. I don't know answer for this. If you know, just comment below. So the next one is dispersal of pathogens through humans is known as arthropochory. If the plant pathogens are dispersed through wind, it is called एनीमो कोरी. इफ इट इज प्लांट पैथोजेंस आर डिस्पर्सिंग थ्रू वाटर इट इज कॉल्ड हाइड्रोकोरी. सो दीज आर ऑल द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ नेम्स. एंड द नेक्स्ट वन इज सिंगल सेल्ड आस्कस इज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाई सिंगल सेल आस्कस नॉट आस्कोस्पोर. वी नो वेरी वेल दट ऑल द फंगे दट कम्स अंडर आस्कोमाइकोटा ग्रुप विल प्रोड्यूस 8 नंबर ऑफ आस्कोस्पोर इन एन आस्कस. वेर एज बेसिडियोमाइकोटा विल प्रोड्यूस 4 बेसिडिया. वेर एज आस्कोमाइकोटा ग्रुप प्रोड्यूस ऑलमोस्ट ऑल आस्कस कंटेन्स 8 नंबर ऑफ आस्कोस्पोर्स. There is a little variations also will be there, like trichoderma. If you take trichoderma, it produce 16 ascospores. If you take podospora, it produce 512 ascospores, something like that will be there. So here the single celled ascus is produced by podospora leucotrica. I think it causes powdery mildew of rose or maybe I'm not sure. If you know, just comment below. I was not good at, you know, the castle organisms or something like that. So if you know, just comment below. So the next one is PR proteins are accumulated in vacuole and apoplast. So the next one is toxins are accumulated in apoplast nucleus.